Both development and what it means to be a developer is rapidly changing. A lot of this comes down to how you interact with AI. One of these tools, Cursor, makes it really easy to build things with AI, but only when it has the right knowledge. Today, let's talk about how to add docs to Cursor, both indexing docs, using existing documentation, and also searching the web from Cursor's interface. We'll also talk about a few rules that are helpful to add to make sure that you get the best out of Cursor. You ready? Let's go. So here I've just got a stock Next.js application, and let's say I want to replace everything on the homepage with an input form. So let's do that now. So I'll just say to replace that should receive an email, and then it should send me an email when I click that form. So we'll go ahead and do that, and it shouldn't have too much trouble generating this basic UI. Now, what happens though when you go a little bit deeper in how a framework works? In this case, we're using Next.js. Oh, you may not know this, but Cursor actually includes docs by default that it's indexed. Now, like with any LLM, there's a cutoff date, so we'll also want to look at what happens if you're looking at newer things that are just added to the framework. So over back this way, let's go ahead and accept everything. We'll just kind of YOLO update this for now. So it looks like it finished everything. It looks like we do need to use client here since the whole page happens to be this. Obviously, you usually keep the thing server side, but this will work in our use case. So now we've added this. However, on submit, when we handle submit, it just alerts right now. So we want to actually handle this email logic. And let's say we want to move this over to an action. So let's ask Cursor to do this. And to interact with docs that's already indexed, you can simply search for docs and then hit enter and then search for something like Next.js. Now these are the official Next.js docs, but again, there's a cutoff date. So I could say like using this, like add an action to handle this and we'll see what it does. So it should convert this component at least to some kind of server action, and we'll see if it can do it based on the Next.js docs that it currently has. Now, in fact, if we look over here, you'll see that it's actually indexing, looking at individual indexed items to figure out how to actually do this. Server actions, form mutations. So it's actually indexed all those and now it's looking them up. Now, it may be that whatever you're doing, let's go ahead and just accept all of this, but it may be that we need to interact with more from the actual live documentation. So I can say something like, make sure you check the, and then here you just want to use the web. So web like this, then you can search for whatever you want to find the most up-to-date patterns. All right, so I'm gonna have it go search and just make sure that this is the way we'd wanna do it. So if you have existing documentation, you can index that. If you wanna look at something that's more recent to the framework, use the web command. All right, so that's the first thing I wanna show you. The second thing I wanna show you is how to index docs that don't currently exist inside of Cursor. So for instance, if I wanna add resend to send emails, those docs are not indexed by Cursor. And I can figure that out very easily by searching for docs. And if I start to search for resend, you'll notice that they don't exist, but I can add a new doc. So let's do that. I can click add a new doc here. And then I simply have to provide the name of kind of the base of the documentation. And what it will do is start to index the documentation. I'll click confirm, and then it will simply start to index it down this way. And in fact, you can find this by just looking. You'll see it's starting to index these pages. It's finding all the different endpoints that need to be indexed. So perfect. Now we can interact with those resend docs. So I'll close this down, jump back over here. We'll say add email sending whenever someone fills out the form. So now it's going to use those docs that is just indexed to make sure that it can add everything it needs. Now you'll see here, it asks me to allow it to install the recent SDK for Node.js, and then we'll actually build this functionality out based on those docs that we just scanned. Now, just like with the existing docs inside of Cursor, this may get out to date. So if that happens, I can just use the web again, or I can re-scrape that as well. So we can go into settings, Cursor settings right here. We look at the indexing and docs. I can come down here and just simply refresh that, and it will refresh those docs. Now, all of that happens kind of behind the scenes, and I can keep using resend as I want. Now, the last thing I want to talk about is adding Cursor rules. Often you can actually direct Cursor to first use your docs that you've already scanned, and then if it needs to use the web. So let's create a Cursor folder. So I'm going to come over here, we'll open the sidebar, and I'm just going to create a .cursor folder, .cursor like this. And if you do /rules and add this as a file, quick tip, it'll actually create the folder and the files here for you. So I could say something like documentation rules. And then I'll say, whenever you're using some kind of package or framework, first check to make sure that they exist in my scanned documentation. If they don't, then use the web command. So you'll notice that's what I've done. I've asked it first to check that it has docs, then secondly, to use the web command, and finally, to ask the user to provide a link if it still can't find something. Now, the nice thing here is you can actually just pass individual links. So even if you find like an example repo that implements something you want, you can pass that exact link to Cursor. It'll scan that and then go from there. So if I came over here, let's say we were trying to add this express endpoint and we didn't add all the docs yet in this particular case. I could say like add this express endpoint using And then I could just pass web here and then pass in this actual link. Now you don't even need to use the web command. You could just paste that in and it will scan that for you. Now this is really helpful when you're grabbing an example repo, or in this case, a single documentation page, and it will actually scan that, figure out what to do, and then build out your functionality. Well, I hope this was a big help in understanding how to use Cursor to interact with documentation, both built into Cursor, on the web, or even your favorite framework, tool, or library. Well, thanks so much for watching. I'll catch you in the next one. Happy sending.